First of all, to integrate this, we have to make sure we do partial fractions and then we integrate these two little fractions. Do not just put down natural log of x squared plus x, because this is a quadratic, right? Anyway, factor this, we can take out an x, and then we have x plus 1. Now, let's go ahead and look at the integral from 1 to infinity. For the first fraction, we must have some number over x, plus the other fraction, some number over x plus 1, and then the dx. As you can see, these two are just linear factors, right? So the top right here, there will just be numbers. To figure this number out, all we have to do is go back to the original and then cover up the same denominator. And you have to ask yourself, how can you make this factor zero? Well, x has to be zero, right? In that case, what you have to do is you put zero into the other x. And that's the cover up method. So yeah, 1 over 0 plus 1 is, of course, just 1. And that's very nice. Just put on 1 right here. Now, we look at this right here. The denominator is x plus 1. We go back to the original and cover this out, right? And then we have to ask ourselves, how can we make x plus 1 equal to 0? In that case, x has to be negative 1. And we put negative 1 into this x. So we end up with 1 over negative 1. And of course, that will be negative 1. So that's how you do the cover-up method for the partial fraction. And now this is so nice because we can just integrate, right? Now, integral of 1 over x, we get natural log absolute value of x. And then this is the minus, so let's put that down. And then integrating this 1 over x plus 1 is just natural log absolute value of x plus 1. And we have the negative right here already, right? And yeah, some people will say you should put a parenthesis there. I will put it down for you guys. Anyway, that's the integral part. Now, don't forget, we still have to put this in your parentheses, and then we have to go from 1 to infinity. Here is the deal, though. If we put infinity to here, we will get ln of infinity, which is infinity. If you put infinity to here, we get ln of infinity plus 1. The result of that will also be infinity. Infinity minus infinity, we have to do more work. This is how we can handle this. Because the inside here is just two natural log, we can combine them, right? So this right here inside is just natural log absolute value. And the truth is, the absolute value doesn't really matter because everything here is positive. But let me just put it down anyway. Stay positive all the time, right? Anyway, x on the top. And then since you are minusing, so it becomes a division like this. And then the x plus 1 inside. So that's the combination of this. And then you just go ahead and plug in the numbers. Keep in mind, whenever we put infinity to here and here, the idea is that we are taking a limit. So technically, we shall supply somewhere that the limit as x going to infinity of natural log absolute value of x over x plus 1. Let me just put down this right here as a note for you guys. To do this, we can just do this inside out. Especially the inside is just a rational function. And the easier way to do the easiest way to do this is pay attention to the top. That's like the only thing you have on the top. It's just x. And on the bottom, it's just x. So yeah, x over x is just 1. So all in all, we get natural log of 1. And we get 0 for that. So the idea is, when we put in infinity here, we are taking a limit. So we actually get the first part being 0 when we have the infinity to here. And then we have to put the 1 into the x. So we minus natural log absolute value of 1 over 1 plus 1, like this. Now, this right here is, of course, 0 minus this, which is negative natural log of, this is 1 over 2. So that's 1 half, like this, absolute value. Of course, absolute value doesn't matter anymore. But the last thing is, this is just like a negative 1. You can put this to become a power here. So you are looking at this as natural log, let me use a parenthesis now, 1 half to the negative 1 power, like this. And you can just work this out, because this is like saying natural log 1 to the negative 1 is 1, and then you have 1 over 2 to the negative 1. And this is just a regular 2, right? So all in all, the answer is natural log of 2. So that's it, right? So that's it. Now, you see, the improper integral here, it's a finite value. That means this right here converges because we just did the computation. We can be sure that this right here also converges by the integral test. Of course, you should also have to tell me that this function here is positive, decreasing, and continuous on this interval. But you just draw the picture on your own. Anyway, we do know this right here also converges by the integral test. And now I'm going to show you guys what this is converging to, all right? So here is the deal. We are still going to do partial fraction. I will factor out the n this time, like this. And then, of course, this is a sum as n goes from 1 to infinity. Let's open parentheses. And for the first fraction, we have some number over n, and then add it with some number over n plus 1, like this. What's this number? Yes, it's 1. What's this number? Yes, it's negative 1. Why? Because we did it over here already, right? So it's the same kind of thing that we do. But this time, though, we don't integrate them. This right here is telling you that we are going to have an infinite sum. Here's the deal. We are going to put in 1 for the n first, and that's going to be the first parentheses. It has two fractions. The first one is 1 over 1, which is 1, and then we minus, right? This is a minus, and we put 1 right here, which is 1 over 1 plus 1, which is 2. Congratulations, this is the first parentheses. And then the next one, when n is 2, put it here, we get 1 over 2. And then minus 1 over 3. And then we pretty much just continue. Next one plus 1 over 3 when n is 3, right? And then minus 1 over 4. And then so on. And as you can see, this right here is going to be a telescoping series because in the middle, you see, this right here is negative 1 half. This is a positive 1 half. Of course, they cancel. Likewise, this right here is negative 1 third, can be canceled out with the next one very nicely. So just keep canceling, very nice. As you can see, in the front, we have one remaining term, and the reason is because from n to n plus 1, the difference is 1. So you have one term in the front left. And you also have to remember, you have to write down the n term for it. And because we only have the difference being 1, we just need to put on the nth term. And the nth term is just this right here, namely 1 over n minus 1 over n plus 1, like this. And technically, I should also put on plus dot dot dot, and because this right here keeps on going forever. Now, if you recall from the second parentheses, this guy got canceled out with the number in front, right? This guy got canceled out with this number right in the front. Now, if you look at this parentheses, let me tell you, this number is going to be canceled out with the number right in front. And so on. But of course, we are going to leave it right here. You have to write down the nth term, because this right here is technically the nth partial sum formula. And let's just write that down. We will have 1, and this is minus 1 over n plus 1. Partial sum formula. And then what we do is we are going to take the limit, because this right here keeps on going forever. Take the limit as n goes to infinity. And be sure to do this step, because sometimes this might contribute some negative number that you have to pay attention to. But in this case, we have 1. And of course, negative 1 over infinity, this right here will approach 0. So this is just minus 0. And all in all, the answer to this right here is equal to 1. So as you can see, this improper integral converges to ln2, which is about 0.693. And this infinite series converges to exact 1. Very nice. And finally, just keep this in mind. Either both of them converge or both of them diverge. However, if both of them converge, they may not converge to the same value. Most likely, they will converge to a different value. Like this is an example for that. So keep this in mind. And again, we can only calculate certain sum, right? Just like this right here. This is a telescoping series, and this is how you're supposed to do it. And you guys can check out my other videos for more examples of the telescoping series.